can save me. Only you can deliver me. Only you can set my mind free.
You know what I always tell everybody before you come on the line to anoint yourself? You must anoint yourself because it's like you're going into a different house and you don't know half the people that's in that house, and you want to make sure you're covered and protected. We're going to open up in 1 second of speaking in tongue, but those that have a heavenly tongue, because we're going to shift this atmosphere to where God wants it to be, and we're going to release some stuff even right now. So let us get started. In Jesus' name. Father God, we invite you onto this line. We've already said you are welcome into this place, which is us, the body, the temple that we are, Lord God, your vessels, your living vessels, Father God. Father, I ask that you have your way, you know, on this whole time, Father God. For those that are coming on and yet to come on, Father God, quicken their spirit, because they don't want to miss none of this. But God, even if they miss it, I thank God that it's being recorded so they still can get it. But sometimes you need to be the first partakers of it when it's being downloaded and released. Robo Shaka. So we thank you right now in the precious name of Jesus. I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, amen. I must say, when I was given this topic, it came on as usual. All these topics God is preparing. It's a preparation is going on as he's teaching us, you know, about portals and doorways and gates and entranceways. You know, there when you go researching it, there's some stuff on it. But one of the things I learned, oh my shatai, look at Pastor Annette over there from New York. One thing I learned, we bless the Lord, that is the simple fact that God will download in us. Because remember, he says, my sheep know my voice and they obey. And the scripture that this comes from that I'm talking about, because not everything's in the Bible, and we know that, you know, we have to call the deep to the deep, hallelujah. But Matthew 16 and 17 says, then Jesus answered him, blessed, happy, spiritually secure, favored by God are you, Simon, son of Jonah, because flesh and blood, mortal man did not reveal this to you, but my Father who's in heaven. I got revealed by portals because of the Lord. I went upstate one year. God sent me upstate to this monastery on a mission, as usual. And I've always taken my photograph, my camera, to always photograph the journey. I'm sitting by the river and a bench, and I'm looking at the brick wall, and I noticed the wall was like a weeble wobble. I'm saying, God, what is that? He said, that's a portal. Later on that day, I found out what was in there and what was feeding that portal. Because behind the curtain and where they was having all the leaders sit, and they requested those in the leader to come down into the center of the floor, and they wanted them to hum. They told them to come and release the power. Now, I was sitting with Mother Bronson. Mother looked at me, and I looked at her, and we did not move. Because the word of God says, we don't hum, we moan and groan. We later found out when they talked about on the break that they felt that power. I had left my phone, and the Lord said, go back in there and get your phone. When I went back in there, God said, pull that curtain back. And when I pulled back that curtain, I saw the biggest Buddha I ever seen in my life. So that power they was feeding and that they was humming about, what they was feeding, was the portal to the demonic realm. I myself have experienced several levels of portal happening since I've been here in Montana, very heavily for the spiritual realm. To this day, I cannot and have not found my Michael Kors handbag that had my credit cards, my ID and money. I'm upset because I didn't get to spend the money. The credit cards and ID I got back, but that Michael Kors was from my mother. And I know what happened. The enemy took my bag, went through a portal that I did not get. And up until a couple of days ago, once again, I got attacked again, twice. I had not one, but two set of dentures that have disappeared. But tonight we're going to learn about portals, demonic as well as heavenly portals. And Apostle was able to reveal something to me today, which I'm excited about. And we're going to do some exercise on the end, because all of y'all got power, and we're going to tap into that portal for me for some stuff. Amen. So I'm going to let Apostle Patricia come on. Are you there, Apostle? Apostle? Okay, see, the enemy upset with her.
Amen.
Yeah, she's going to come on. She's going to come right back on. I already know that. You see, that's how, when you start dealing with stuff like that, you know the enemy don't want this information released. But I'm going to turn this over.
Praise the Lord. I'm on, Apostle.
I know. I see you. I'm going to turn this over to you so you can get started. And I suggest you have your pen and paper. It's going to be a lot of information, and you need to have it so that you can be right in tune. All right? Apostle, take it away.
Amen.
Amen.
Before I just start opening up this, I want to say a short prayer. I know you already
prayed. Go ahead, Apostle.
Pray over this, because this has been a heavy topic. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, giving you praise, giving you honor, and giving you glory on tonight. Father God, I ask that you come in. Holy Spirit, you're welcome. Come in, stay with us, be with us, God, leading God to all truth and understanding. And I'm praying that everyone that comes on this line, and I greet you on tonight in your respective places, that God would illuminate your spirit, open your eyes and your ears, that you receive what thus saith the Lord from his word. And we pray right now in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. I'm going to tap in and I'm going to tap out.
Amen.
When I first received this assignment, and I want to thank you, Apostle Gibson, for this particular topic. I have to say, when she first presented to me, and it's just like anything else, how God speak to me. Sometimes he just give me one word and I have to figure it out. It's like a puzzle piece. When she mentioned portals.
Amen.
And okay. All right. So I pondered over it. Anytime I get a lesson or something that I been asked to teach on or speak about, I make sure that I go before the Lord with it, pray about it, study it. We got to be like the Bereans. We got to check out everything.
Amen.
It's true or not, and go to our word. Because we know that some of the things that we have been taught over the years that has not always been correct in the teaching. So it's like dismantling everything that we know and starting all over again. So with that said, I just want to say that portals are really just open heavens.
Okay.
Portals are really just open heavens. And there's a lot of teaching with this, because I said, you know, in the scripture, you can find a whole lot of information and what God has said about portals in the Old Testament as well as the New. So I'm going to try to give you what God downloaded in me and relay it to you, and I'm hoping that you will catch it. Some things we have to catch in the spirit.
Amen.
A lot of people say, well, I receive it, but you receive it, then you go off and then you lose it. So what are portals, and what does the Bible says about portals and how to close them? Portals are doorway, gates, entry and exit, a way in and a way out, a door and access. According to the Bible, it is a spiracle. In English, this is spelled S-P-H-E-R-I-C-A-L. It is a spear, S-P-H-E-R-E. Sometimes that is something that is round and three dimension. A spear does not have any flat surface or vertex of an edge. Now, examples are like a basketball, world globe, marbles. We know those are all round, which is unlike a circle, which is flat and two dimension. It is an open space that offers divine protection through which angels and heavenly beings can come and go without demonic interference. And God has designed these portals to originate in the third heaven, then travels through the second heaven and on open up onto the earth. So one thing I want you to keep in mind, that we live in a physical realm and a spiritual realm.
Amen.
And there are three portals of heaven that I will tap in on tonight. However, there are actually seven heavens. I will only be taking talking about three of these portals of heaven and what they contains. I will not touch on the other ones, which is another teaching for the sake of time. And maybe at the end of the lesson, I could probably give you the other ones if you like, if the time permits. So the first heaven is the sky, clouds, and rain. It contains the physical world in which we live and which is the earth. The second heaven is the outer space where the stars are. Third heaven is where God abode, the throne of God. Now we're going to be talking about gates, doors, windows. Now, when I looked up the scriptures about windows, the one that I picked out was out of Malachi 3:10, where it says, bring all the tithes into the storehouse and open up your window, they have no room to receive. But this one I picked out, it can be said a lot about this particular scripture, but I won't expound on it, like I said, for the sake of time. And I want to take away from the lesson. And that has been, on this particular Malachi 3:10, has been a lot of controversy, I would say, scripture that a lot of people debate for the most part, which is one of the things. But they all are considered portals, the gates, the doors, and the windows. So let us go to the spiritual portals. But before, let me tell you something. Before I go there to the spiritual portals, let me just go back just a step or two. And that way, when I get into deeper into the lesson, you'll understand what I'm trying to say. Not everyone has the keys to open the heaven. I don't care how great we are, how well of a speaker we are, what kind of gifts we got going on, and how much you fast and pray. All of you want, you know, when you pray, all the keys will never be given unto you if it was not given from the beginning. And I'll tap into that when I get into the deeper portions of this lesson. And if you're not under an open heaven, you can't never be led. And see, this is why a lot of us miss out, because we don't want to unite with the ones that can cause us to be able to tap into some of these that God has for us. We get scared, we get intimidated and all this other stuff instead of just stepping out by faith. And faith has a lot to do with it. You might not think so, but it is. And you wonder why things are not operating for you or happening for you, because you refuse to, I would say, obey. That's what it is. You're not just like, I'm not listening to that man, I'm not listening to that woman. But if you know that they're a man and woman of God, a true man and woman of God, they're giving you something that God has given to you to help you. You're not rejecting that person, you're rejecting Christ.
Yes.
I just want to point that out before I moved on with spiritual portals is any person, place, or object that acts as a channel for unrelated spiritual beings to have and form the physical realm that we know on earth. Now remember also, we are spiritual beings in a human body, a three-part dichotomy, body, spirit, and soul. Now the gates of heaven, this is a portal or a door between the higher levels of heaven and the lower level here on earth that has been opened once, which is the first realm, which is the earth, and the second realm of heaven, and then the third realm of heaven where God abode. Now, there are two gates to a room, one to heaven and the other to hell, with each gate having a guard. Guard meaning there are angels that are guarding those gates. So what I'm saying about when, because it might be a question about what you mean by two gates to two rooms. You can have one room, but neither one of these occupy the same space, because heaven is different and hell is a separate place itself. Okay. So I'm hoping that, you know, you understand that part. In other words, you can't operate in the same area. The gates of hell is a portal. The gates of hell are not a physical place on earth, but a spiritual place that those who live in sin rather than Christ will enter on the day of judgment. Now, when you go to Hebrews, I think it's 9:27. Let me see if I want to go to, let me see, we can go to Hebrews 9:27. Yeah, let's turn, if you have your word, go to Hebrews 9:27. When I stated that who live in sin rather than Christ and have not accepted the Lord as their personal savior. Those are the ones enter in on the day of judgment. So Hebrews 9:27 says, and as it is appointed for men to die once, but after this, the judgment, okay? The gates of hell is also known as the door of hell. One scripture out of Matthew 16:18. Now I'm going to kind of go slow so you can get these scriptures that I'm giving out and you can write them down to read them at your leisure also. So if we go to Matthew 16:18, still talking about the gates of hell. So Matthew 16:18, and I'm going to try to take my time so you won't miss any of this, that some of this stuff I can say to you off the top of my head, but I'd rather write it down. I'd rather be able to go slow so you can, you know, get it. Because like I said, a lot of times.
Time, Apostle. This floor is for you. If we have to do a two-parter, we'll do a two-parter.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, they better catch it while they can. Some things you got to catch. You just can't wait to receive it. Because the next time it come around, it might be another way that God shifted. You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
But anyway, let's go to Matthew 16:18.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. 16:18, and it was talking about the time on the transfiguration. It says, and I also say to you that you are Peter. We talk about Peter, the apostle. And on this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. That is what they're talking about, those keys. Out of all the apostles, Peter had the keys. And then I'm going to go back to explain all the rest of them that had the keys and how they operated. So when Jesus was asking Peter, who did men say he was? And also he even asked Peter, who do you say I am? And then Peter answered him and said that you're the Christ, the Son of the living God. Mm-hmm. He blessed him and said, flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, but his Father in heaven. And that was the scripture that Apostle had gave out of Matthew, that some things we just won't get unless you get revelation knowledge from the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
That'll drop on you. I don't care how much you pray and fast and all this stuff, but if God did not give it to you through this Holy Spirit, and I have a scripture for that also, when I know for a fact that we will not receive it, because a non-spiritual person will not believe or know or understand the spiritual things, such as open portals, what we're teaching about what I'm teaching about on tonight. And 1 Corinthians 2:14-15. Let me go there right quick before I go on to tell you about the reason why they won't receive it. So 1 Corinthians, let's go there. God, I thank you. Like I said, we got to be like the Bereans. We got to go and search out stuff. So 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Don't take a person's word, everything that they say, but get in the word for yourself.
Yeah.
So 1 Corinthians 2:14-15. And the reason why I said that a non-spiritual person will not believe or know or understand spiritual things such as these open portals I'm teaching on.
Yeah.
Because the word says, but the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God. Okay, for they are foolishness to him.
Yes.
Nor can he know them because they are spiritually discerned.
Mm-hmm.
And in this hour, that's one thing we need to pray for, is discernment and discernment of the gifts of discernment. We have discernment of gifts, I should say. Because some things we just go off the cuff, off the top of our head, or out of our flesh, and it won't work like that.
Mm-hmm.
Because without God, we can do nothing.
Yes.
And won't know nothing either. So I just want to give you that particular scripture to tell you and see that they won't even receive what this thing is really all about.
Apostle Patricia, before you go further, let me read the Amplified because it really tears it up more. But the natural, unbelieving man does not accept the things, the teachings and revelation of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness absurd and illogical to him, and he is incapable of understanding them because they are spiritually discerned and appreciated, and he is unqualified to judge spiritual matters. But the spiritual man, the spiritually mature Christian, judges all things, questions, examines, and applies what the Holy Spirit reveals, yet it himself judged by no one. The unbeliever cannot judge and understand the believer's spiritual nature.
Thank you for that. I meant to say that I'm a King James Version person.
No, it's okay.
And so people read from different passages of each, you know, different individual Bibles, and I'm glad you read that.
Out of
the Amplified. I do have Amplified and a couple other ones, but it just seemed like I'm favored by the King James. So thank you so much.
That's fine. You read it from what you get. And as I see stuff and I see something that just like chop, 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 chop. Now, amen. I know everybody got that.
Praise God. Yeah, well, I hope they do, because I don't care how much you think you got it, going to get it. But if it has not been revealed to you, the revelation knowledge, you're just not going to get it. And sometimes people are really not seeking the face of God. Yeah. I always say that they're seeking the present, P-R-E-S-E-N-T, but not the presence. And sometimes even the presence, we need to seek the person of God.
Amen.
And if you have not been taught these things, we're not going to know. Like I said, a lot of things we've been taught over the years, I know I have, and I have to admit that. Some of the things have not been correctly talk to us. It's like dismantling stuff and starting all over again, and that's fine, but you have to have those persons that God have entrusted this word to be able to get it downloaded into them, to give it over to you, so you'll be able to live by these words. Okay, so let me move on. So when I said Peter received that revelation knowledge, that could only be revealed by the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And Jesus was saying to Peter that there would be no restrictions, in other words, when he said the gates of hell should not prevail against thee. That meaning the church, us, the saints, the blood washed, the born again, that will not be able to have any restrictions, us as believers. Now, Jesus tells us that the gate of hell, the gates of Hades, sometimes they call it Hades, hell, whatever, it's still hell. And the resistance of the enemy to maintain his ground will not prevail against us. So as we share these things with people, like we're on the line and other people's outside of this scope, our churches or organizations, wherever we may be at, that it will not prevail against us. So as we share these things, once again, with people, the enemy will not prevail, and his efforts to keep them ignorant and deceived concerning their identity. Because see, a lot of times people, they think that, okay, I'm this here. No, but a lot of times we don't even know who we are. And most of the time you have to have someone come out and more or less say to you or show you that the benefits and the things of God that he has for you will teach you to know who you are in Christ.
Amen.
But if it's not taught, they're not gonna know it, nor they're gonna receive that. So the gates of hell separate you completely from God. Mm-hmm. Separate you completely from God. Isaiah 5:14. Let's go to Isaiah 5:14. Let me see Isaiah. Oh Lord, thank you, Jesus. Isaiah 5:14. I'll show you something there about the gates of hell. Jesus, my God, hallelujah. Isaiah 5:14. Therefore, Sheol, meaning that's the word for hell, S-H-E-O-L, that's the word for hell, has enlarged itself. And open its mouth beyond measure, their glory and their multitude and a pomp, and he who is jubilant shall descend into it.
My God.
So therefore, hell has enlarged herself and opened her mouth without measure in the glory of the multitude, what they're saying, and out of the word that he that rejoiced shall descend into it. It's been told that the hollow out ball, remember when I said it was a spear, like a basketball. So the earth, the hurt of the earth, that place called hell is approximately 16 miles from the earth's surface. So right now, you're closer to hell than you are to the airport. Hell is a real place. Hell is a real place. It's the center of the earth. It's not on the earth. It's in the center of the earth, the heart of the earth.
My God.
Mm-hmm. And people say, I'm living hell down there. No, you ain't living in hell. You don't want to go to hell. Like I tell you, ain't nothing in hell Pat want.
Amen.
Right. Nobody wants to go to hell. The hell wasn't made for man.
Yes.
My God. In the beginning, in the book of Genesis, the Bible speaks on how God, he created the heaven and the earth without form or void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. Mm-hmm. As we know it, we have often believed and taught that there was only one heaven. When you read it in Genesis, where it says God made the heaven and the earth, but like I indicated, there are more than just that one heaven. And when you look at Genesis, you can read that at your time, on your leisure time, Genesis 1, Genesis 2, you can read that, where how God created the heavens and earth. Satan can't create nothing. God nothing. Created him. You see what I'm saying? See, when you look at, I want to say Lucifer, and I get into that, but when you look at, he was Lucifer before he got kicked out of heaven. Now he's Satan, the devil, the enemy. He's just a copycat. He can't create anything.
Nothing.
That's right. Nothing. He tries to, and this is where some of that deception come in, mm-hmm. to make us think as believers that he's all of that in a bag of chips. No, he's not. He's doomed to hell. It's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time that his number gonna be zero. And then you have all these people he's trying to take as many as he can with him. And right now, if we need an open heaven, we need one now. If you look at the world the way it is today, if we need an open heaven, we need it now. And there is something, and I don't want to jump too far ahead of this here, but I heard somebody the other day, and I don't like to, I said, I want to correct them so bad. And a lot of times I have corrected people, but I did it in love. I try not to, you know, say stuff to try to hurt people's feelings. And I am considerate sometimes. But I don't want to be ignorant of the word of God, because when they say something, everybody else will take it and run with it. Mm-hmm. And you think it's gospel truth. But I have done that in my own time. Somebody said something to me and I took it as gospel truth and I repeated it to somebody else, and I quite sure they repeated somebody else. So we have to be careful of that. Mm-hmm. And somebody had said, oh, let's go behind the veil. And it looked like it just slumped in my stomach. I said, why are they saying go behind the veil? Don't they know when Jesus died on the cross, the veil of the temple was torn top to bottom, right?
Yeah.
Did they not read the word out of that? Let's go to Matthew. Well, is it 20? Oh Lord, did I write it down? 27:51, I believe it is. Yeah, let's go to Matthew. I'm gonna show you. Matthew 27:51. See, when you learn the purpose that Christ came, oh Lord, I'm telling you, when I started studying this for the last couple of weeks or so ago, this thing messed me up. It was some nuggets and things that I thought I knew, but it was bringing some of this back to my remembrance also. Mm-hmm. And I thank God for that, to be able to give this information out to someone else that might not know it. Because see, a lot of times we think that we're so great, we know everything, and we don't. This is how we're learning from each other, mm-hmm. and supposed to anyway.
Thank you for teaching me.
When we go to Matthew 51, it'll tell you, Matthew 27:51, about that veil,
right?
It says, then behold, the veil of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth quaked, and the rocks were split. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then the other scripture coming out of Mark 15. Let me turn in myself on Mark 15, because I want you to get this about this veil. So when you hear somebody say that, they got to be correcting them to go to the word. The word does not say that. That's why I tell them, you show me that in the word, and then I believe it. Other than I ain't trying to hear nothing, because that means it's going to shift me to some stuff that I'm going to be in error. And then I'm the one that has to, you know, go before the Lord and repent. Yes, Mark 15 and verse 38. It says, then the veil of the temple was torn into top to bottom. So there are scriptures for that, but talking about the veil. And let's go behind the veil and we're going to go. Don't they know? Oh, let me, one more scripture. Luke 23 and I think I wrote this one down. Did I write that one down? 23 and 45. Let me look here and see if that's the one that I wrote down. Because like I said, some of the stuff I can say off the top of my head, but I want to be sure that you see it also in the word of God, not take my word for it. Lord, I thank you. I give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, yes, it is. I did write that one down. Luke 23, verse 45. Then the sun was darkened, and the veil of the temple was torn in two. And that's when they said, they cried out with a loud voice. He said, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit.
Amen.
This, he breathed his last. Come on now. So when somebody keep telling, come on, and I hear a lot of conferences, that's we're having a conference going behind the veil. And I said, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. That's one I won't be attending. Thank you very much. I just want to point those scriptures out to you. When you hear this, you'll be able to know the correction that is being said. Because see, that's how the enemy, he think he's slick. He tries to pull that veil over your eyes, and that's that yes. veil of blindness and darkness, so you can't see nothing. That's the veil that he has tried to pull over the people. Like I said, what they're doing now, the economy and all the stuff in the world, and it just happened in the United States. This thing is global. Yes, he's deceiving absolutely. A lot of folks. He's deceiving a lot of folks through this fear tactic and everything else that's going on. They're so confused, but God getting ready to bust it wide open. You hear what I say? Getting ready to bust it wide open. Oh my God. So I'm just excited. Y'all have to forgive me because when I start talking about the word, I get excited. I don't know about nobody else. I get excited.
Amen.
I get excited. Amen. See, I'm real. This word is going to me first.
Absolutely. It is going
first. And that's the way I look at it when I'm reading something or doing a class or teaching. It applies to me first. And I have to take that and eat it. But now a lot of people will call this thing that I'm teaching tonight about the portals. Because see, and then I'm going to say this because some of them still working at witchcraft. I'm going to just put it out there. This is no new age stuff that I'm teaching.
Amen.
And ain't no occult. Because that's what someone might say is not of God. The devil is a liar. Like I said, we got to be like the Bereans. We got that, what in the book of Acts 17:11, you got to search the scriptures to seek out the truth.
Yes.
Know the truth, and the truth will do what?
Set you free. All
right now, come on. You can mess around with it if you want to. The portals of heaven, let's move on. We can read that in the Old Testament also. See, when you talk about portals, it's been here all the time existing through the prophets in the Old Testament now as well as the New Testament. Yes. So we can read that in Old Testament. Go to Psalm 78. God, I thank you. Psalm 78, verse 23 and 24. This is when God himself had commanded the clouds from above and opened the doors of heaven and had rained down manna on them, meaning the Israelites, if you read that, what was going on back there in Exodus, to eat and given them of the bread of heaven. God provided manna from heaven, even though they complain about it every day, but they still being fed and they had provisions made.
Amen.
But he had to make sure that food came through a channel that was not tampered with. So God opened a portal in heaven to deliver the food to the Israelites. Because see, And I'm going to say to you about those different heavens, the reason why some stuff was held up. Oh, mm-hmm. my God. And you can read that like from, I believe it was the book of Daniel.
Mm-hmm.
Another example is Jacob. God started to communicate with Jacob. Mm-hmm. And he had an encounter with God mm-hmm. that changed his whole life. Now, so many people, when they read the word about Jacob, said that he wrestled with the angel, but he was, Jacob was really wrestling with God.
God.
He said, I want this here, and I'm not going to let you go until you bless me.
Mm.
My God. See that? Mm-hmm. He saw a portal. As he was lying there, he saw a portal open in heaven where he saw the angels ascending and descending.
Ascending, yes.
If angels... And the Lord was already here, so they walk with us. They still ascend and descending with your answers. Because when we pray, God hears us.
Yes,
I forgot about that now. He hears us. And a lot of times, he said it's denied. It could be delayed, which Daniel, you can read that, why some that he was praying for. And I'm going to touch on that in a few minutes to let you see that it's out of the scripture. So Jacob was designed to be transferred above the stars.
Mm-hmm.
He wanted something from God, and he was willing to stay there. Now, how many of us willing to stay there when we want something from God? We won't even get on our face. We won't get on knees.
I want it, and I want it right now.
As old as I am, I'm 71 years old, and sometimes I've been on my knees, and I couldn't hardly get up. I had to roll over on the floor to get up and pull up on something, okay? So, but either way. Yes. I'm going to tell you the truth. Yes. When you get a 30-day, it ain't easy to get down to try to get
I
back.
I know that's right.
Nevertheless, I'm going to hang on to something if it ain't nothing but a chair to get down on my knees. But I'm going to tell you about a story if I have time with that going before the Lord on your face. So as I was saying, Jacob was designed something from God. Now, Jacob was designed to transfer above the stars. He wanted something from the Lord. In this same scripture, it talks about Jacob's ladder. Now I'm going to say, okay, that's what they're talking about, Jacob's ladder with stairs up mm-hmm. and down. That was going up and down. Now we know. Mm-hmm. Same thing with Lucifer at that time. He was up there in the abode with God in the throne. And he was caught coming from earth. And God asked him, hey, in other words, I'm paraphrasing, where you coming from? Mm-hmm. Oh, I've been going to and fro in the earth. Now that's in the word.
Yes,
he said it. It's in the word. I've been going to. He was down at that time, and I found out through my reading, he was messing with Job at that time, trying to accuse Job. Lord, I said, Jesus, this book is something else. And that goes to show you how he messes with our minds if we let him. And this is how some of those portals are open, whether they're demonic portals, whether they're spiritual. That's why I say you have to keep in mind we're spiritual and we're flesh. Simple as that. So. You can read the scriptures out of Genesis 28 verse 10 and 18. Yeah, see, this is the thing that we need to know, what we are capable of, what we have been given access to, what is granted unto us. Oh my God, I'm telling you, God is awesome. He is so awesome. He wants his children to know he loves
us. Yes, he does.
He loved us so much. And he said, I will not have you ignorant. Not have you ignorant. And it says in 28:10 and 18, now Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran. So he came to a certain place and stayed there all night because the sun had set. And he took one of the stones of that place and put it at his head. And he laid down in that place to sleep. Then he, Jacob, and behold, a ladder was set up on the earth, and its top reached to heaven. And there the angels of God was ascending and descending on that. He saw this. He saw this. And it said, and behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord of God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie, I will give to you and your descendants. Mm. Also, your descendants shall be as dust of the earth. You shall spread abroad to the west and to the east, to the north and the south. And in you and in your seed, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. When the Lord tells us that he never seen the poor forsaken Lord, seed begging bread, our seed is our children. He's not gonna see us begging. We don't have to beg. We're gonna beg, better come on up. Ain't no begging time in the kingdom. Mm. Because everything that we need, God has already provided, already has given it unto us. And all we got to do is ask. Some of us don't ask for nothing. We just, you know, and it said tells you life and death is in the power of the tongue. What you speak, you will eat thereof. So speak some good things. Speak those things into your life. So anyway, 15 says, behold, I'm with you and will keep you wherever you go and will bring you back to this land. But I will not leave you until I have done what I've spoken to you. And this is the thing when I talk about lying on your face for things you want from God. We get up too quick. We don't carry. I would use the word carry because I'm careful about using that word carry because it reminds me in the older days where you had to tarry for the Holy Ghost. You ain't got to tarry for the Holy Ghost today. Not in this day and age. Amen. Because the Spirit of God is within us.
Yes.
We ain't got to tarry and all that. Because I came up under that old school where they'll knock you in your back, your head, and everything else on that altar and say, baby, get back down there. You ain't got it. You ain't got it. And then you have you calling out Jesus. And those things that was taught so wrong until now. Oh my God, I thank you for the grace of God.
Yes.
Thank you for his grace and his mercy. Mm. And it said, then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, sure the Lord is in this place. And I did not know it. A lot of times God is in our presence. We don't even recognize it because we're so busy doing everything else. We miss that time. We miss the time and that we should have with God. And a lot of times we've given time to everything else but him. We give him the crumbs. Mm-hmm. Now I'm guilty of that. I'm guilty of that. And I had to repent.
Me too.
Because things I kept saying, well, God, I'm gonna get into my word today. I'm gonna do this one. And I lied. I did something else. And then later on, I'm so tired and beat down. I can't keep my eyes open. I'd be trying to read the word, the book fall in my face. All right, just say ouch. If you know what I'm talking about. I'm just being filled with you because that's the only way you're gonna get this thing. We say what we do and we can fool man, but we sure can't fool God.
I know that's right.
Man. Verse 17 says that he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
Amen.
And said, in the last verse here, 18 said, then Jacob rose early in the morning and took the stone that he had put on his head, set it up as a pillow and poured oil on top of it. And he called, and I'm going to read 19, and he called the name of that place Bethel. Mm-hmm. But the name of that city had been Luz. The name was Luz previously, but Bethel is the house of prayer. Oh, yes. Jesus. Thank you, God. So another example is Daniel. And I love that book of Daniel. Now that the book of Daniel has already been fulfilled. I think I taught that when I was doing the Antichrist, that book has already been fulfilled. But it still applies to us today if we read it and see the connection to it with this. Daniel, when he was praying and fasting for 21 days on behalf of the Israelites for their sins, he was waiting on an answer. But it was held up.
Yes.
God had opened up the heavens already to release the answer. But the enemy tried to block it just like he do stuff now. This is why we have to strategic plan how to get around the enemy because he is so shrewd. He think he's slick. And what he want to do is try to trick us.
Yeah.
A lot of times fall for the thing we're not careful, we'll fall into it. And then we wonder how we got there. But then Gabriel had to send for help. And I love it when I he said, which was Michael, the archangel, to help him fight. I said, he had to send for the heavy duty boy, the archangel, Michael, to help him fight. See, the first heaven is ruled by Gabriel. Mm. And the fourth heaven is ruled by Michael. Like I said, I'll tell you about these different heavens. And what it contains if I have a time to do that. Now, I'll give you a couple more about open portals in the New Testament. A door. portal in heaven was open for John the Revelator. You know who he is. Where he heard the voice of God and also saw a door open in heaven. And that's coming out of Revelation 4. Giving you scripture, that way you can go back and read it for yourself. My God, I think in Revelation 4, verse 1 and 2. Talking about a door, portal in heaven was open for John. And it says, after these things, I looked and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was like a trumpet speaking with me, saying, come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this. And immediately I was in the spirit. That's what he was saying. And behold, a throne set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. Even when John was told to come up higher. Now listen to me. In order for him to go up higher, he had to go through a portal. The door that was open for him. There are portals in heaven that are open, but man can activate those portals. It's either for good or for bad, but a lot of them, like I said, if you have not been given those keys, it's like I'm going to touch on Peter with these keys, because I said I was going to go back to that. Out of all the apostles, Peter had the keys. When Jesus walked the earth, he moved with open portals. Wherever he went, he commanded portals to be open.
Yes, yes.
Heaven was always open to him and to communicate with his Father. The portals was on him. To relate to the scriptures, when Jesus said, I only do what I see my Father do, and so can you. When we talk about spiritual signs and miracles and wonders, which is another area, that I don't want to shift too much over there, because that's something else that can be drawn out with that, and maybe I will touch it if the Spirit lead to give it to me. But looking at Revelations 4, 1 and 2 again, after this, I looked and behold, a door open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard, it was a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. This was what John saw and heard. Now, Matthew, let's go there, because I'm going to show you something in this here, if I can kind of break it down. Matthew chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. God, I thank you. I thank you. Matthew chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. See, John the Baptist was the one that baptized Jesus.
Amen.
And in this scripture, it tells you when he had been baptized, meaning Jesus, came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens was open to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And suddenly a voice came from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son in whom I'm well pleased. Now, I'm going to share something with you. Jesus had 3.5 years on this earth to do ministry. Mm-hmm. This is why I said about time. I didn't want to get into the time of things, because that would lead to other scripture I have to open up. But when you see that, when he said that I have need to be baptized, he told them that. He had to baptize him. And that goes to show you that when Jesus was being baptized, he was showing obedience. It was a baptism of repentance, even though he knew no sin, nor even committed any sin. What he did on the cross and shedded his blood and took on all our sins and nailed them to the cross. The heavens was open unto Jesus, and he saw the Spirit of God, and he heard the voice of God from heaven, which was the Holy Spirit, the Holy Dove that landed on him, that on his shoulder. So the purpose of Jesus coming is for us to carry an open portal wherever we go. Mm. There's an open heaven above us right now. It's constantly open. And like I said, just a thought hit my mind, right? As a believer, we're like him, made in his image.
Amen.
Jesus came to replicate himself. Mm-hmm. When we arrived at a place, the atmosphere, have you ever been in a place and the atmosphere changes? Sometimes we don't know why it changes, but we know that it shifted some kind of way. Mm-hmm. It's because we're carrying the portal. Everywhere we go as a believer, here we go, we're carrying that, and people don't know it. And sometimes they look and say, oh, they look strange. I don't know, they look funny. They don't realize what they're looking at. Mm-hmm. They don't understand it. Now, how can these portals be open? Through unity, and that coming out of the book of Acts 2:1. And see, right now, today, we don't have unity like we should. Everybody trying to do their own thing. Mm-hmm. They're not trying to come, but there's power in agreement.
Yes.
You start agreeing with each other on the things of God. We can shift some stuff. I mean, oh my goodness. But you hardly find anybody that would like to, or should say like to, want to be able to help you be able to move some things with God within. So Acts 2:1 says, when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place, just like we are now. We're in one place on the Zoom. Might be in different various cities, but we're in one place as the body of Christ. We're all connected. Mm-hmm. Say feet don't need to touch, arm don't need the head and all like that. We're connected in the body. We're connected. Might not want to agree with it, but we are. Also, it can be opened through prayer. That's Acts 4:31, chapter 31, verse. Everybody want to do their own thing. That's why we can't get nowhere. And when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. My God, and you don't think that you should have some Holy Ghost boldness to speak the truth of God? Got to speak it out. Might make some people mad, but that's all right. God got you. He gonna cover you, especially if
Amen.
It in your flesh, man. And trying to come out your flesh. Because when I tell people, if you're gonna say something, yeah, but don't let that flesh rule you. And you speak it, prophesy, do it from your spirit, man, not from your flesh.
Yeah, because it's
not gonna profit you nothing. And also, it's open through obedience. When we talk about Matthew chapter 3, 16 through 17. Yeah, Matthew 3, 16 through 17. And we can't, this is why we're so divided. We just don't want to seem like to come together. And we're all learning. Ain't nobody Amen. Arrived. I Amen. Know I haven't. I'm still Amen. Learning. Nobody arrived. I'm still learning. Some things I thought I knew, I didn't know it. And I love Apostle Lydia here this last month. She said, some of us need to shut up.
Amen.
Shut up. We talk too much. And I agree with that. And sometimes we can talk ourselves out of a blessing.
My God.
Amen.
We do it all the time and wonder why things are not moving for us. And wonder why things are not going the way we think they're going, because we think we know it all. We don't know it all. We don't know it all. I know I don't. I'm still learning. I'm eating it up. I'm eating it up every chance I get. Verse 16.
Amen.
Verse 16 said, when he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were open to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, alighting upon him. So those are how things are open, through unity, prayer, and obedience. Some of us just don't want to be obedient to the things of God. We think that we're doing what we're supposed to do, but we're really not. We're really not. See, when you're under open heaven, those signs and wonders and miracles will take place.
Yes, ma'am.
They'll take place. Hallelujah. But you got to know that you're under open heaven when you start operating and the gifts that God. See, a lot of times we want to depend on our gifts and don't have too much to do, even though people in certain places or high as you look at, oh, they got such a beautiful gifts and this and that, and they can prophesy, they can do that, they can speak it up. But sometimes those are just talents. When you hear them singing, it's talents. It's not gifts, it's talents. They can sing good, they can sing awesome. But some of that stuff is not to the glory of God.
Amen.
So once a portal is open on earth, it is permanently open, and the devil knows that they're open.
Yes.
He's all around there, him and his little imps, trying to listen and get stuff. That is why those demonic spirits appear around that open. Don't think that they're not there now. That's why I said,
yes, they are.
The spiritual realm and a physical realm, and we got to know that. And we open up portals through prayer, praying those religious prayers.
Big time.
Gossiping. Big time. Now, there's some things you can talk about without putting somebody in the grave. But by speaking things into the atmosphere,
yes,
because death and life is in the power of the tongue, what we speak, what we eat. And we know anytime we speak the word of God, and what he wants us to do is give his word back to him. So when we give his word back to him, it's not going to return unto us to him void. It's going to come what it's been set out to do.
Amen.
So in our churches, we do the same thing, do all kind of crazy stuff. I'm telling you, Lord, I see why God had some of these churches closed down, and some of them are not going to be able to open back up.
Yes.
And it ain't church as usual. They trying to push it. Like I was saying when he was talking several months back in last year, we going to have a great revival. I said, the devil is alive. You ain't going to have no revival until true repentance, until true repentance come to your heart. And not because you got caught. Not because you got caught, because you were sorry for what you have done. That's when it's going to come. So now, what can I say? So it comes through songs. A lot of this stuff, the songs that we listen now, like I was saying to Apostle, I listen to all kind of music. I really do. And sometimes I have to catch myself, because this is how the enemy, he's so slick and shrewd. He'll start bringing back up stuff from years ago. And I find pat my feet a little bit. You know, I say, no. Let me turn this thing off. You see what I'm saying? Because it's so easy to open it up.
Yes.
It's easy to open it up. Because it says, the old man has passed away. Behold, all things become new. That creation in Christ is not no more who I used to be.
Yeah,
I saw something the other day that kind of grieved me a little bit, but I couldn't say nothing, and God wouldn't allow me to say it.
Amen.
But if you say you have came out of the world, and then you trying to teach me, don't do this and don't do that, because I said when I was coming up, it was always, you can't do this, you can't do that. And I used to say, well, what can we do? But that's the way I was raised up. But now I'm saying, if you are a new creation in Christ Jesus, your life has been changed. You say you knew, then why are you going back to that old stuff that would take you right straight to hell? That thing bothered me, and I'm saying, I can't teach to nobody if I'm doing the same thing.
Absolutely.
Don't judge me. Let me tell you one thing. The Bible said we can judge, because we're going to be judging. But we have to judge righteously.
Righteously, yes.
According to the word.
Amen.
Now, I'm not saying that everything is a sin, because God had me to write some stuff down. And I'm saying, Lord, am I supposed to say that to the people?
Yes.
But it that God drops in my spirit, it is to give to the people, and I can't hold it. So we know through music, remember, Lucifer was the chief angel of music.
Amen.
So when you hear all this music in church, the binga, binga, bunga, 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 they're not ushering in nothing but them demons. You can tell when there's music played up under the anointing.
Yes, hallelujah.
Because it will usher up in the presence of God.
Yes.
And then that open heaven is what you want, because it makes it conducive to do the things that you need to do.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lord Jesus.
My apostle.
Don't shift it another way. This is why people, you see them hopping around, shouting, jumping all over chairs and in and out. And the next thing you know, they haven't not gotten nothing. They go out the same way they came in. And they do the same thing the next week, you don't see no change. You don't see no improvement. I know, but I've been around a lot, but I've been in ministry over 38 years. So I've seen everything from the back door to the front door, the side door, everything else. Okay?
Say it.
So also, oh my God, this is the one I said, Lord. I said, Lord, am I supposed to tell the folks that?
Yes, tell us. Tell us.
Please do.
You know me. Tell us.
It says also when a church practices homosexuality and everyone in the church is gay and practicing that lifestyle, it opens up portals.
Oh, come on, Corda.
Jesus.
Same as a church that operates in pure holiness, it brings about righteousness. That same spirit will operate in there. And then when I mentioned to somebody a while back, if you're doing that, it's going to trickle from the head down. Oh, don't trickle from the head down. So you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, it does
trickle down to the congregation.
Yes, it does.
Because if the leader got a funky life and living a dog's life, you're going to be living one too out in the church and outside the church.
Tell it, Papa.
That is true.
You can't fake the funk with the Holy Ghost.
I know that's right.
Either you're going to get it right or you're going to get on back out there and live for the devil.
Yes.
And go straight to hell if that's what you want to do. Like I said, ain't nothing in hell Pat won't. When I was out there in the world living for the devil, I did everything that I thought I was big enough to do. But when I came to Christ, I meant what I said.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I try to live that before my children, my family, and have them think I'm crazy, but I know what I'm talking about. I know it. See, they looking at the old path. They looking at the old path, but they don't know. I'm not even in this world. I'm of another world.
Amen.
Man.
And also, this other thing that he dropped, and these are two that I kept saying, Lord Jesus, what you go? I said, I'm gonna get in trouble. It says masturbation.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Open
better preach
portals. A person who cannot control the urges to masturbate or watch pornography are almost always plagued with devils. Maybe more than one.
Come on.
Now I heard somebody say, oh, Lord Jesus, who said that? I heard that in the spirit. But I'm just giving you what God downloaded. And I kept saying, God, am I supposed to the same? But these are portals. They're open.
Amen.
We open up stuff that we shouldn't open with.
Yes.
Come on.
And so in the world of the spirit, according to Jesus Christ, the sexual thought is the same as the sexual act. And we can see that in Matthew 5:28. We talk about lusting. Dealing with the porno. This is not the person in those books or photograph, but you imagine somebody else's wife or husband you're sleeping with.
Mm. Yes.
Nachos, as Pastor Dawson talk about husband. So yeah, nachos.
You're good.
So you imagining with somebody else's husband what you can do or wife. See, this is what happened when we use the power force of imagining stuff. Mm-hmm. And the enemy plays on that filthiness. Mm-hmm. Now, I had asked the question the other day, is masturbation a sin? Yeah. A lot of y'all might disagree with me. No, it is not a sin. I don't see nowhere in the Bible where it tells masturbation is sin, but it's filthiness. It's filthiness. It's plain old filthiness. So when we have that use of powerful force of imagining stuff, I said a mind is a terrible thing to waste. Sometimes when we get into, and I often tell a brother of mine, and I was hoping he was going to get married, this and that, and I'm still hoping he will, because he can if he want to, but he just won't still be a player. But the thing is, I said, sometimes you can play with yourself for so long and love on yourself until you, when you get a real woman, I'm just going to tell it like it is. You don't want that. Because you're so used to making love to yourself. Mm-hmm. Get out of here. Let me get off. Hey, hey. That's all right.
You better say it anyway.
I know ain't no children on here, but these are some adult things that we should know because it is real. I've known people that tell me that I talk with people every day, and they'll tell me they used to be a masturbation queen. I believe it.
Oh, wow.
Now we got feelings. Like I said, I was telling somebody the other week, I'm going to get married again at 71. Yeah, what's wrong with that? I'm not dead.
Amen.
If I was you, I wouldn't want no man. And I didn't. I'm a widower. I'm a two-time widower. So am I not titled to get married if I desire to marry me?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, amen. I'm worth my weight in gold. You hear me?
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
Amen. So
I ain't telling them. I might not need him, but I want one.
Yeah.
I just put that out there. Now that's off the record. That's not a part of the lesson. That's off the record, but I'm gonna just tell you like it is. I'm being real with you. Because when people come at me like that, you know I gotta clap back in a nice way. So let's get back on these portals. Portals, they do stay open until we close them. Also, the demonic portals, not unlike hell, hell will never close.
Mm-hmm.
Which is for the devil. Hell wasn't meant for man, as I said. The devil, the hell was made for the devil and his imps, which they give to go there sooner than what we think. But Christ is on his way back, soon to come back. And we're playing, and we still teaching the three blind mice, the three little pigs, all of that stuff that don't mean a hill of beans, how to get your soul saved and stay under the covering of God.
Amen.
Because the time that you might get back out there might be the time that you won't be able to make it back in.
Amen.
Nothing to play with. He's nothing to play with. We have the power to open the heavens to gain access anytime we'd like, but your heart got to be right. You can't come in any old kind of way before Christ. Do it. When you're in Christ, you live on the open heaven as a born-again believer. A lot of people say they're born again, but they're not. They just got a religious spirit. They don't bit more know Christ than a man in the moon. And that's when I was thinking about a couple of months back when God said he was going to separate the wheat from the tare. I had a sickle and I was cutting. He said, stop cutting. I said, why? He said, because I'm going to do the separating. And he's been doing it.
Yes, he's
been doing it.
Amen.
He's separating to see who really belongs to him and to who's not. So if you don't get these words that are being taught over whether this Zoom or someone that you know that's been teaching to get you to come on up, you're going to be left behind. And if you go to hell, ain't no going to be nobody but your own.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Because you don't got enough word. You don't got enough word. You don't got enough teaching to know better.
Amen.
God, Jesus. So when we're trying to close some of these portals, we got to denounce and announce Christ and repent of your wrongdoing and make sure you're in a healing place now when you do, because the enemy will try to play tricks on you. And I'm going to share something before I close out. I'm getting ready to close in a few. I said that I was going to tell you, and then I'll tell you about my testimony. I guess I'll put it in there, God, Lord needs. But out of all the apostles, Peter had the keys. And the day of Paul didn't even have the keys. He had to seek out the priest in order to get divine direction. God, read that thing and look at it. The only one, the last one that the apostle that controlled the heavens was Enoch. With him, you know, he left this earth and he couldn't even be found.
Yes.
And another one was Elijah. Mm-hmm. When he came, Elijah the Tishbite, nobody knew who he was. When he went down to the River Jordan, he had Elisha there, and he said, will you see me go up? He went on up and didn't see him no more after that, after he dropped his mantle. Oh, my goodness. But then again, when I started searching, see, this was the same river that John the Baptist baptized Jesus. The same river. Mm-hmm. Same river. And nothing is growing unless the heavens are open.
Mm.
Nothing's growing. And in Genesis, you read that, because nothing really took place until Christ had finished creating everything. And then he said, about the multiplication of things. So those keys right now, when even with Moses had keys, and then Moses, and then I think it stopped at Joshua at that time. I believe it was, it was Joshua. Those keys was there. And one other thing dropped in my spirit, because a lot of things we practice, we do, because somebody else tell us to do it, or we done seen somebody else do it, and we want to do it and see if it worked. Let's talk a little bit about sage burning briefly. People use that, they say, for cleansing the area to help close a portal that was open. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, even though sweet grass, I don't know if you ever heard of sweet grass, is another one to cleanse your space and helps to attract good things. Now, when I was a kid in Georgia, we used to walk the tracks, and there was a plant that was called sweet grass. And we used to pull it up from the roots and suck all that sweetness out of that sweet grass. So I know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
But personally, I do not burn sage of any kind.
Amen.
I really don't. I'm just going to say that. Mm-hmm. Now, I love candles, all different beautiful candles, shapes, colors, because in the harvest time, they're beautiful. Some candles I have had in my house, I haven't lit in years. Now, I'm not sitting around no candles all in those circles doing those seance and all that other stuff either. Okay? But the thing is, there have been people trying to introduce me even to yoga. Tell you, that's another teacher with that yoga. When someone asked me about that, I said, yogurt? My daughter said, Mom, it ain't no yogurt.
Yes, it is.
They thought it was the funniest thing. And I said, you know what? That tells you a lot about me right now. I don't do yoga.
That's right. That's right.
I don't do yoga. And those, when I'm talking about portals, are some things I just want to share with you to open up your mind to see some of the things we do that we feel is so innocent, and it's really not. Mm-hmm. Pendulums and what is that? The Ouija boards.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see them too much. The boards, they took them off the market, whatever they do. But though other devices are not spiritual ports, they do allow to flow now between worlds, but a better way to try to connect. So if you got any of that stuff, you better go ahead and throw it out.
Exactly.
The Ouija boards and all this stuff that you count these beads and. Brenda, I see people doing it, but I just shake my head and say, Lord, Emmer, let me get a whip around that stuff. Because right. See, some spirits, they attract, and sometimes spirit, they transfer too, if you're not careful. This is why I tell a lot of people, when you're doing ministry, and I have a deliverance ministry, and you can't be touching man your head, your hands all on somebody, call yourself helping, and you got your life is not clean.
Amen.
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 You're messing Amen. Up. And you wonder Amen. How you got spirits on you because you don't want you out of order.
So Amen.
People are not trying to tap in these things because somebody tells you that it's okay. Sounds good, but it's not biblical. It's not right. And sometimes we know it's not right, but we go ahead and do it anyway. So I just wanted to throw that out there to you. But when we have spiritual waking of these portals or spirits, now in the coming years, we can start to renew our minds and deepen our spiritual practices that we can turn into a rebirth. In other words, become new. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. So John 10 and 17, and I'm getting ready to close this out. John 10 and 7 says, I am the door of the sheep. Mm-hmm. My sheep knows my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. And John 14 verse 6 says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And that is through Jesus Christ himself. Amen. Now, Amen. If anyone wants me to go over right quick before we close out about the other heavens, I said there were seven heavens. I only touched on three. Anybody want me to go over that right quick before we close out?
You can't do quick. We'll have to do another part on this because this is a lot of meat right here. I have over.
Okay, so we don't have time to do it. That's fine. Then
we still got some time, but I have wanted to talk about some of the things you said. Then we can always go back to that. All right, is that all right, Apostle?
But that's fine.
Okay. When you talked about, we can open and close portals. You was on, and some people weren't yet. Until you revealed that to me this afternoon, you was talking to me about it. And I told you I was going to wait till tonight on the group. And then you talked about why the Lord told me to wait till tonight, the touching and agreeing and the power that will be here on this line. I need to open up with prayer for a portal. Since you said the portal's upon us, the same portal, the modern portal that took my coarse handbag and my two sets of teeth, I declare and decree in the name of Jesus that you return my stuff. Open that portal up right now and release what is mine and return to me. I'm asking Amen. Everybody to touch and agree with me with this power, because God had told me wait till I got on the line and you said in unity there's power. So Lord,
yes,
I
it Amen.
It right Amen. Now, as you know, listen, open up that portal where they took out my stuff and return it back to me. It belongs to me. I need my stuff. It should never been taken, but it did not hinder me from stopping to going to do what God is called to do. A Amen. Lot of time these demons take our stuff and move it, thinking it's going to stop us, because I don't care whether I have teeth or not. I have anointing. The teeth don't make me anointed. But see, a lot of people are doing Amen. That, and that will stop them. See, that's why yeah. the apostle told me, if you got a lad, do like this. So I was kind of like this and this and here. But I need to know, and I declare and I decree, and I thank everybody for touching and agreeing with me, that the portal, the same portal that opened and took, will open and return to me what is mine. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
Yes, Amen. And I want to add to that, if I may, apostle. It's called, right, it's called a wasting spirit. A wasting spirit.
Wasting
spirit. That's what it's called. Come to take everything from you that belongs to you. That's why I told you today, some things we can call back, call those things forth, if be not as though they were, you know, because when you say, when you catch the enemy, he's a thief, you catch him, he got to return it sevenfold. Now I'm gonna be on,
hallelujah,
you need your pocketbook back with your money in there and everything. So I do stand in agreement with you on that, that if you speak it, I believe that God will allow you to receive everything that was stolen from you that you have indicated.
Amen.
Amen.
The devil takes stuff from us that belongs to us, because that's his way of distracting us from doing what God has called.
Yes.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
And I thank you for that, because one of the things I love about this, all of us in different places, we're all on water court. We're all learning. Nobody knows anything. We, you
that's
know,
right, man.
That's right, man. I'm the youngest apostle. I'm the youngest baby apostle. I'm the youngest one in years doing this. God has tapped me into so many that got years that as I talk and connect with y'all, I'm able to glean and get stuff, you know? And it's a gleaming process. And that's why God gave this assignment, and he told me, you. I'm nowhere equipped. I've had experiences with portals and different things. And like I said, even that old crazy, but there was a wealth in you that needed. I thank you, and I thank God.
Yeah, because when you, possible. When you said that, I said, "Oh Lord Jesus," I said, and I think I shared this with you. And I said, "Look, like I get the hearts up." I said, "Just like them, some of them stiff necked folks I had." And I said, "God, why you always giving me the heart cases?" But I don't mind studying. I don't mind reaching out. I don't mind trying to pull in and just get before God and ask the Holy Spirit, "Help me with this. Help me to understand what I am saying and be able to speak through me." But one thing I want to say too, while we're on the line, is that oftentimes when we move in new places, I know a lot of us has moved in new homes and old homes, we need to learn how to clean those houses out, go through them and anoint those
places. Amen. Amen. That's so true.
Died, murder folks and kill folks and all that stuff. So we need to come in and each time, like now, still anoint your house up and cover your foundation.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, you talked about sage. Okay, I don't know if a lot of y'all know or not, but I was groomed to be a fifth generation white witch. My family's into white witchcraft. Sage is a no-no. That's straight up witchcraft. When you smell sage and burn it up, that's witchcraft. It's not no cleansing. That's an inviting demons coming to your house.
You're opening it. Okay. Yeah, that portal.
Candles, I can't burn candles. I can't stand the smell of candles. There's something about something in the sense of the candles activates my Holy Ghost, sends it in a rage. I guess because as a child, all them candles we had lit and different other stuff. So that's like a warning, warning danger, apostle, you know. So I definitely don't participate with that. I thank you for explaining about how to open them, how to close them, you know, all these scriptures that lined up with it. If anybody has any questions before she goes on to give us the other ones, that's fine, because I got out what I need to do.
I don't play the pops. Get yours, huh? I love it.
Jesus.
God is so good.
What an awesome study today. Awesome.
Yeah. Thank you.
Awesome. And we all needed it.
Yes. Amen.
We all needed it.
Yes.
Exempt.
That's
would
right.
God gave you? Because he's preparing us.
Yes.
Yes.
Ephesians 6. We need to be prepared and yes. understand what God is doing in it. In this hour.
Amen.
We're not in the same era. This is a new era.
That's right. That's right.
New era. Amen. So there's new things we need to pick up and learn and go forward. God was saying to me this week, we need to go forward. We need to go deeper. And we have to go higher.
Amen.
To obtain the things that he wants us to have.
Amen.
I received the teaching. It was really excellent. Excellent.
Thank you so much, Apostle. I appreciate that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Apostle Patricia, thank you. Because, with these new portals, I never knew much about them. But through the grace, you open up my eyes to see that there's good and bad. And
yes.
then you know that to be cautious about what I touch and what I get in the company of, because these portals can be open and they can come to you. And then you have to be able to distinguish, discern the right and the wrong for the portals. So it was a blessing to get to know what portals were and
praise
what they function.
Praise God. Praise God. To God be the glory.
I really enjoyed it too. This is my first time.
Welcome.
And, Apostle invited me, so I put it on my calendar and make sure that I didn't miss it.
Yeah.
I really got a lot out of it too. And it says student on there, but my name's Monica.
Okay, hello, Monica. How am I doing, Monica?
Okay, Apostle Dawson, I need a comment out of you from y'all down yonder.
Oh, I didn't know they was on the line. I didn't see.
Hey, listen, there's quite a bit of people on the line too.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I always enjoy hearing Apostle talk.
Hey, Pastor.
Hey, how you all doing tonight? The thing is, I've been smiling the whole time because last week, that's all the Lord had me studying was on portals.
Wow.
And and just learning more and more about operating as Ephesians 5:1 says that we must be imitators of God.
Mm-hmm.
And being under the open heaven, it's a powerful message. And I want her to go on and list those other heavens. So we all will be walking in full authority, proclaiming and also dismantling generational curses. And the Lord even talked to me about the markers on our blood that were portals from our family in our parents' life, in our parents' parents' life. So this is all just 100% Holy Ghost feel.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's just a blessing to know that we all
are
in the same prayer chamber here in the same
information.
Because when you said he had you studying, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Because like you said, we're being equipped. Like you said, we don't know what's about to happen. But it's an opportunity to close some portals that we have open. We're not aware of or that we are aware of. Get them closed and to prepare to open some other ones. And like I said, when she gave me that revelation, that never even dawned on my little limited mind. Don't you know you can open? I'm like, what? Really? And that's why I said, no, I'm going to wait with the group, not knowing that the information she said, touching the green. And because I said, there's going to be enough people on that line with power. So I didn't want to play around.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We thank you for that. We have Pastor Elect in my mind. Annette, would you like to say something?
That's my pastor, girl. Come on here.
Oh, my goodness. I'm just going to say, well, praise the Lord to everyone. And I have to give honor to my prophecy teacher, Apostle Lydia Adams.
Yes, yes.
And I give honor to Apostle, hello, it's Gibson. Apostle Patricia, this is my first time hearing you. And a couple of months ago, the Lord had spoken to me. He said, I need for you to study about portals and doors.
My God.
And I said, well, why do I need to study about that? And he said, I need for you to study about portals and doors. And I had no idea that tonight that this is what you were going to be speaking on. But when Apostle Gibson posted it on my Facebook, I said, you know, she's always inviting me to these things and I never seem to have the time to listen and attend. So I put a reminder on my phone today to remind me to dial in. And I have to say, you have really taught me a lot about portals and doors and how some things that we were taught wrong. I have to piggyback off of Apostle Gibson. I was not aware that you can open a portal, but you can also close one.
Yeah.
So yeah. I have a lot of notes here. You have given me a good start to even dig deeper into
Praise God.
I thank you for creating the foundation for what the Lord is asking me to look into, because now I can dig deeper because of you.
To God be the glory. Yes. Belongs to him.
You see, this is what happens when you obey. And since you was delaying, Daddy was pushing. And you finally did the click. Now you understand. Elder Lack Raymond, I know you got a comment.
All I can say is praise the Lord. Praise the Lord to everybody. Glad to be here and glad to hear exactly what I heard, because like you said, you know, I was just feasting. I may be a chef, but I had my plate out. I had my platter. And I was eating. As you see, I had my tissue just wiping my mouth. That was good. God bless you. Thank you for allowing the Lord to use you, because you know, part of my testimony, God delivered me from homosexuality. So when you hit that, I was like,
look at that.
Masturbation, that's something that, man, I was like, I'm so glad she said that.
Wow.
Because, the enemy tries to fight you in different areas.
Yes, he
will. In different areas, even people that I knew that need to come out, you know. And I said, you know, the Lord said, no, I got your back. He said, I delivered you. I can deliver somebody else. But everything he said, when you talked about the portals, because there's so many open doors, we don't even realize the open doors, the eye gate, the ear gates.
Yes, so many. Yes, that's right. It is.
Man, it's all the way around. You know,
that's why
we have to be covered in the blood.
Amen.
Covered from top of our head to the bottom of our feet. I am so grateful.
Amen.
I'm so grateful for this ministry.
But see, that goes to show you God knows what we need. Now, I had no idea. God knows that. But, you know, I said, Lord, am I supposed to say that on that? I can put something else in them little lines, but no. But
because you know what you confirmed? So you confirmed something for me.
God get all the glory. I take no credit. God get all the glory.
You confirmed something for me, because I was talking to the Lord about some things. He said, what did I tell you? And when you opened your mouth, I said,
praise
you
God.
You just spoke to me about that this morning. He said, keep pushing. Don't praise care if nobody God. Else don't let you keep going in the vein that Amen. I told you to go in. Don't be ashamed. He said, that's I wiped away all shame and all fear and all guilt. That's all gone.
He loves us.
You
know, the truth.
You
told
are a new man. Yeah. And so I thank you for being obedient.
We got a lot of things in our closet, and some of you open up the doors, all them skeletons will fall out. So we all have done something in our life. So I thank you for that. Much. But see, I tell you what. And my boss might come out and say, but that's true though, because we can't fool man, but we can't fool God.
But thank you so much. I'm so grateful that you did.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Like I said, all glory belongs to God. Hallelujah. I'm still learning myself.
Apostle, now I'm going to let you open up the floor and give us the other dimension, the portals, because I needed everybody to let you know that you're in the right vain and how much of what you did, your time blessed us, and to find out God has been speaking to various other people about portals. So I'm looking forward to whatever they're going to be bringing out soon too. So Apostle, continue now.
Okay, I just want to touch on two things before I go into the seven heavens.
Okay.
I had to make a confession, and I'm constantly asking God to search my heart every day. I mean, I don't waste time. And God had me to go before when I wind up stretched out before the Lord on the floor for hours. And I was asking God to search me because if there's anything that I was holding on to, anything that over the years that I might have forgotten, I wanted him to bring it back to my remembrance so I can repent of it.
Amen.
And as I was lying on that floor, it began to show me where I had pledged Zeta Phi Beta when I was in college. That's a sorority.
Yes, I know.
And then not only that, when I was boohooing about that and denouncing that, that's what I was talking about, denouncing those things and announcing Christ, because we got to be clean in everything that we do and say. Then it took me back when about the Eastern Star. I had forgotten about that. When we start making these pledges and oaths to these things that people are doing and have done, and with that Eastern Star, you have those Masons in there. We have a lot of bishops, a lot of leaders that are Masons. Mm-hmm. Nobody don't want to talk about that, but they are. And the things that they teach is not right.
Yes.
But the thing is, I had to denounce all of that. I had to really come clean with it, and I thank God that I did. Because many of you don't know, I just had a major surgery in June. I was battling with stage 3 breast cancer. And I tell you, I was on an open heaven. The reason why I believe God didn't allow me to go about it because his grace. And I tell you, I kept asking God how I was going to fight this thing because the doctors kept telling me, you got to have a mastectomy, got to do this because the band say all that stuff. And I wasn't trying to hear it. I said, I got enough faith with me, you, and everybody else. So I had to get that word. And I stayed at my daughter's mouth for over 2 months, just about two. But once I got into that word and laid out in that floor, I was on the open heaven at that time talking to God.
Thank you, Lord.
And when that scripture fell out of the thing up top there, when it came up for dinner, it fell on the book of 2 Chronicles, I believe 2 Chronicles 18, 19, which talk about Jehoshaphat. When I read, because I said, God, how am I going to fight this battle? The doctor said this. I said, but they don't practice Dr. Jesus. I kept saying, no, I'm not going to. God is going to deliver me. Because, see, I'm a 2-time cancer survivor.
Hallelujah.
This is why I know the enemy. Amen. And I kept saying, God, what covenant did I break? This is why it's so important to go back and check yourself. Because I kept asking, what covenant did I break for this to come upon me? But then in the meantime, I was wondering, who am I going through this for, God? But I tell you, I thank God that he healed me.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
I took every test Amen. In the book. I want to take the PET scan. Oh, you can't take that. So expensive. No, I want every test in the book because I'm believing God for this healing. And I'm glad that I did not listen to them doctors because now I got doctors in my family. Okay. My daughter's doctor. But I'm just saying how we can open up things unknowingly. And sometimes it's not so much what we do. People are praying prayers against us also.
Yes.
Don't think they're not praying against us. And God showed me a lot of things while I was lying there, but I couldn't reveal it to a whole lot of people that I wanted to. But I just want to share that. I was under open heaven, laying in that floor day and night, sometimes heavy sedated on the oxycodone. So I didn't know if I was going or coming. But I thank God for that. I just had to get that out because that might be for somebody too to know that God is a healer.
Yes.
You got to have faith to believe it, know it, and don't give up. Keep fighting. Don't give up.
Glory be to God. Okay, amen. Now
let me go on to the seven heavens. Like I said, the first heaven contains the physical world. It is ruled by Gabriel and is home of all the angels connected with the natural phenomenon of the universe.
Right.
The second heaven is ruled by Raphael. It is the home of sinners who are waiting for judgment day. Some of the fallen angels are held there also. As we read the scripture earlier about the ones that are sinners going to be in that particular place, they're waiting for judgment day. The third heaven is Bardell is in charge of the third heaven. The southern half of this heaven contains the Garden of Eden, the Tree of Life. 300 angels of light protects them. The northern half of the third heaven could not be more different, as it contains hell. Not surprisingly, some of the fallen angels of hell here too. The fourth heaven is ruled by the Archangel Michael. It contains the holy temple, the altar of God. Now, Michael was once known and assigned as a healing angel until his role was changed. He became a protector and the leader of the heavenly host against the force of evil. As I was reading one scripture about Daniel, how Gabriel had to call for the Archangel Michael, had to call him to come and help fight. He's because the king of Persia had held up all this stuff. So the fifth heaven, most sources say that Zachariah rules the fifth heaven. Some accounts give this task to the Archangel Sandophon. Some of the fallen angels are held here. Now remember, as well as in the second heaven and the third heaven, remember one third of the angels fell when Lucifer was kicked out.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you see these angels in different areas of these particular heavens that you see, which the second heaven and the fifth heaven. So the sixth heaven, Zubel, was the ruler of the sixth heaven at night, and angels of the Sabbath ruled during the daytime hours. There are angels of the Sabbath and angels of the rest of the week. Wow. All the celestial records are kept here, and choirs of angels are endlessly studying them. The seventh heaven, which is the last one, Archangel Cassiel rules the seventh heaven. God, the seraphim, cherubim, and the throne live here. Seraphim are the highest angelic class, and they serve as the caretaker of God's throne and continually sing praises to God of holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory. Amen.
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 So I end it out there. Ah. God's glory, and he gets all of the praise in the name
of God.
Well,
thank you, Lord.
I want to thank you for your obedience, for your gift as a teacher, your gift as an investigator, faith-believing investigator. You done searched them scriptures, hallelujah, where everything lines up. I thank you for being able to teach us to receive it. I thank God for the video, which will be ready tomorrow for people to sit back and replay it and really get some more nuggets out of it, because God gonna reveal some more to you.
There was much more, but I know for the sake of time, all of it couldn't be stressed out like you really wanted it to, because it leads into other areas of the things that God wants to.
You did an outstanding job.
You did.
These are my pages.
Yes, you did.
Okay, and I got the video. So there's quite a bit that has to be gleaned yet. More revelation for me on something that God is trying to show me about something else.
And he would illuminate.
And I thank you for that. That key thing that I needed to know about was opening and closing portals myself. I can do it. I have that authority. Yep. That's
life and death is in the power of the tongue. I keep telling you, life and death is in the power of the tongue. What you speak is going to take place. It's going
to
matter.
But see, when you line it up with the teaching like that, the revelation was quick for me to pick up.
Right.
You know, we know that scripture, life and death is the power of the tongue. But I never equated it with I can open and close the portals.
Yes, you can.
Okay,
yes.
Now I know that, because now I've been taught it. I'm ready to go in there and tear up some stuff. Thank you, Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
You know, because I am bold and crazy like that, you know. But that was never in my mind. And this is why it's so important for us to be able to come together and get these teachings. Not these pity-pat teachings. I mean, this real stuff we're going to need.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever's coming down at end times now. You know, uh-huh. We got people sitting up there watching, like with the Halloween craziness. And that's why I had to laugh at God. I said, God, we're getting ready to go into Halloween. And these people don't realize they're opening up portals.
Yeah, yeah.
Whether they're dressing their kids in these costumes, that's opening a doorway for them to leave.
Yeah, inviting that demonic spirit.
All these little things. And they think it's a game. No, this ain't no game.
Yeah, they, cute. Yeah, opening up those demonic areas that they don't need to open up.
Right, and they're saying that that's the highest time of the year for them is Halloween. Okay, yes. So, and then when you look in the history, when you go back into the history where it came from, people need to know the history. You need, you know, and like Pastor Lilia said 2 weeks ago, people are lazy. They don't want to research.
Yeah.
I sit down and spend time, you know.
And those witches and all of them, they be praying all year round. Don't think they just not.
I know. Especially all year round, but Halloween is their high day.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's where they do crucifying children.
Oh,
yes,
yeah.
Yes, they do.
Be surprised on blood sacrifices. My God. It's heavy. It's heavy. But to God be the glory on tonight. And I thank everyone that came on and gleamed and got something from it. I thank God for that.
Apostle Lydia, will you take us out in prayer, please?
Amen. I was going to ask for y'all to pray for me.
Okay, what do you need prayer for?
This week, it's a lot of warfare taking place.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
Losing my brother. He died. Then the last week, my other brother, I had to keep him in my house because he had surgery. And then Saturday, my daughter was sick and they had to take her into the hospital. And she had a total hysterectomy.
Wow.
Out of nowhere.
Wow.
Jesus.
And then Monday, I was feeling so bad. And I didn't understand what was going on with my body. Come to find out, I had shingles.
Okay.
And I realized, I understand where they came from, you know, especially us who are 70, my sister.
Stress.
71 and 72. We took those vaccines when we were kids, from chicken pox, measles, mumps. Oh, I can't even get the word out.
Mumps. We know what you're talking about, mumps.
Anyway, and when we get older, that those shots that we've been taking, we have the shingles in those shots. So I realized, okay, that's where it came from. Me, I'm 72, so I'm like, oh God, okay. So I didn't go back and get a shingles shot a long time ago. I should have, and I didn't. But when you get older and you start getting between 55 to 70, stuff like that, it comes up into your body, your system. And it has happened to me now. So I have shingles. I was not going to get on tonight, but I know that I was, when I saw that what you were teaching on, I said, oh, I'm going to be on there. Well, I'm in terribly pain. I cannot sleep at night, but to God be the glory, because I said, God, you know what? Jesus said, God, let this cup pass by me. If it's not, you know, let this cup pass by me. But not my will, thy will be done.
Yeah.
And I'm good. Yeah. I'm good.
Well, Apostle, you know, it's so funny because I was going to ask Apostle Dawson to pray for you as well as whatever she wanted to say, because yeah, I'm hearing something else in the spirit realm. But Apostle Dawson, please do.
Amen. Amen.
Well, I wanted to address...
I can't hear anything.
Can you hear me now? Hello, can you all hear me now? Apostle, I want you to read Mark 1, verse 40 through 41, because Mark 1, 40 through 41 is the word you stand on when your body is being afflicted through the blood, because that shows in Mark 1, 40 through 41 that God is willing to heal, and it's through the blood of Jesus. And also Mark 10, verse 47, dealing with blind Bartimaeus. Because when Jesus sees you, you have to remember that God is in us. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. But I'm going to pray.
Amen.
Father God, we all come to you today in the name of the Father, through the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Through Christ, our sacrifice and our high priest. Lord, I thank you for loving every one of us. And I thank you for joining us together by your spirit, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
Father, right now I ask that you move through each and every one of these people's home, Lord God. Every apostle, every prophet, every preacher, every teacher. But Lord God, move into their family homes. We speak right now and we come against death, because death must behave. For you have given us power and authority.
Yes.
Because we are the ambassadors of the kingdom of heaven. Lord God, as we walk by the Spirit this night, I thank you for your yes and your amen. I thank you for your abundance. And I thank you for the breaking of affliction. And God, anyone that is under the sound of my voice, I decree that you are healed.
Amen.
By the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree that you are free. According to God's word. And I decree that it is established well for you and your house. For anything that has been taken, it shall be brought back.
Yes,
and those who have lied shall confess.
Yes, Lord.
And those who have trespassed against us, Lord. We ask you now, God, to help them and have mercy.
In the name of Jesus. Yes, yes.
Amen. And the scripture she said was Mark 1:40-41 says, and there came a leper to him, beseeching him and kneeling down to him and saying unto him, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said unto him, I will, thou be clean. And the other one was Mark 10:47. One second here. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 4-7 says, they said, Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of divorce. That's the one?
No, 10:47. Mark 10:47.
Thank you.
47.
Okay. When Bartimaeus heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout and say, Jesus, son of David, Messiah, have mercy on me. So we're going to put your name in as Lydia. Heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth. She began to shout and say, Jesus, son of David, Messiah, have mercy on me.
Because
we know by his stripes she is healed. God is a consuming fire, and anything not like God has gotten attached to you.
Yes.
Burn it down to the root. You may be 70, but you still have a lot of life in you that God is going to use.
Amen. Amen.
Just a distraction to delay you from whatever God has been giving you for the school of the prophets that's getting ready to start up soon. You have a whole list of people waiting to come in. And so the enemy thought that he's going to delay you and put you on pause. He didn't get you a stroke. He sure ain't going to get you with that. And let the blood of Jesus Christ circulate through every tissue, every cell, every muscle, every hidden pocket in your body as it cleanses and purifies and sets you free. In Jesus' name. Amen.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
I want to thank everybody for coming on, even my late comer. I love them. The video will be available tomorrow because I'll edit it in a little while. But I want y'all to know in 2 weeks now, our next topic is transferring spirits. Yeah, and that will be done by Apostle Crystal Hosanna from the Daughters of Zion Holistic Healing Ministry. And I'm telling you, you want to make sure you got your notes for this one too. I thank God for all the teachers. Lydia, you need a God encounter. And that's what you need to have a God encounter again with God, Lydia. The enemy's upset with you. He's upset with you. But it's all right. He'll be all right. Because you're covered.
He's going to be all right.
He's already all right.
You've been through so many fires now. It's like, yeah. You know, but they can't take you out. God got too much.
No, they can't take her out.
That's powerful. And you're tapping too many of us. So we will keep you in our prayers. And everyone else on the line, listen, we are family. We're not the two.
And as long as, and I just want to say, as long as she's under that open heaven, she can't be taken out.
It can't be taken out. Your assignment the rest of the week is lay on that floor and talk to daddy.
God, thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. So I thank you, everyone, Lord, for joining us, and God bless you. Like I said, in 2 weeks, the next one is transferring spirits. That's what God gave me. I'm looking forward to how she's gonna break that, because people don't talk about that. That's another thing they don't talk about. But the word of God says, lay no hand on no man suddenly.
That's why
when they be talking about the right hand and fellowship and all that, I don't touch people. You know, and if I do, trust me, you see this here? I anoint myself every time before I go out my house, because I need to heal. Because look, I don't even be picking up other people's stuff. I got my own issues. You know what I mean? So unless God assigned you to touch somebody, don't do it.
I have a question. Apostle Gibson, will you give me a reminder for the next lesson?
I always do that. Look, if nothing else, my people will tell you, I post it on Facebook, I put it on the inbox, I put it through the phone text messages. Listen, I'm very professional for the Lord.
Well, you know, I'm not on Facebook no more, so.
I have your email, right?
Yeah.
That's how I got you. I know, okay. I knew it was wrong, because listen, anyway, I want to say good night to everybody. Thank you for sharing your time.
Good night.
Thank you for touching me.
Apostle Gibson.
Yes.
I've been on here the whole time. I just put my picture up at the end.
I didn't even see you down there. This is Pastor Bowen. This is one of my little spiritual family down in South Jersey. I miss. And I missed her. I'm glad she came on.
I've just been quiet.
That's okay. Look, I don't worry about y'all. Whoever I don't see, whatever, you know, I send you the videos. Hey, look, I got people now reaching out to me, telling me, I'm looking at your video. Hey man, because I want y'all to be fed. Because look, when it starts, know my motto, no punks on the front line. You can't be no punk beside me when the stuff starts. I need some serious warriors that can see it. You know what I mean? Because I'm definitely coming at me, and I can't be fighting for me and you both. Look, y'all standing, you better be, look, because you're standing for Christ. Get equipped, get ready, because it's going to get real critical. Amen.
Amen. Yes, it is.
Would you like to say anything since you've been on the whole entire time?
No.
Okay, I love you. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
God bless you.
Shalom.
Only you can save.